Hey, that's where Dr. Tumiel lives right there. That's his doctor's boat. Got a beautiful place. Let's run up there and see if he got us a cup of coffee.
Hey, that sounds like fun.
Okay.
Hey, Doc.
Good morning.
You woke
me up early in the morning.
To see you.
Good morning. We appreciate you inviting us over here, Doc. You got a beautiful place here. And sure, we've got a fishing report from Jody Wells.
We do. This is from Jody Wells over at Lake Seminole. And Jody says that the pictures below are from his last week's trip, Jeff Faircloth and his two boys, Brennan and Maddox. Also pictured is Tyler, his nephew Tyler. They caught about 50 brim within a couple of hours. As you can tell, with the big party, I take a pontoon boat. Brim beds are still plentiful, bass are so-so, and very few hybrids or white bass, and no specks this week.
That's a pile of fish, let me tell you.
That is a mess of fish.
Okay, and we've got another one to make and a correction to make.
Okay.
And apologize for folks.
Well, yeah, we were one day off, but we were
one week off.
1 week off?
Yeah.
Were we a whole week off?
Yeah.
Anyway, the Mexico Beach Artificial Reef Association is going to be having their kingfish tournament, and it is going to be Saturday, August the 27th, and it will be held at Mexico Beach, Florida. The tournament will begin at 5 in the morning and end at 5 p.m., and the weigh-in is going to be over at Mexico Beach Marina between 1 and 5 o'clock, so make sure you take your family and go see all the fish being weighed in.
Okay, and Doc, they got some big prizes there.
Yeah, very, very big prizes. King mackerel first is $3,000, second $2,000, third $1,000. Wahoo is $1,000 for first prize. Spanish, $1,000. Spanish still running that late in the season?
Yeah, Spanish are real plentiful right now in St. Joe Bay.
And the rules?
That's
fine right there. That's enough information right now. We got to go fishing. Last week we kind of dropped the brim fishing trip that my brother John and I went on down in the Apalachicola River, and but we found it. Everything is straightened out now on our schedule. So I tell you what, let's take a break and go fishing with brother John.
Our folks, Dr. Tumiel and his staff, they're fast, they're friendly, and they're efficient.
We treat hepatitis, indigestion, gastric ulcers, diarrhea,
constipation,
colon cancer,
colon polyps,
hemorrhoids.
Hi, I'm Cindy. Give me a call to schedule an appointment.
Hi, I'm Lynn. I check the patients in and I work with the charts.
Hey, I'm Jessica. I'm Dr. Tumiel's nurse. If you have any questions, just give us a call.
Panama City Gastroenterology, located at Northport Professional Center.
Ready to help you make the right selection. C&G buys, sells, and trades guns. C&G will buy one gun or a collection. Look over this area's largest selection of quality firearms. C&G Sporting Goods, home of the experts.
I tell you what I like about Corum. 7 days a week, and their breakfast out of this world. My favorite is the world-famous Corum Heavenly Hash. Corum Steak and Egg, 804 South Tyndall Parkway.
Ikenfina Canoe Liver is located on beautiful Ikenfina Creek. And folks, it is one of the most beautiful trips you'll ever make. You can rent a canoe or a kayak, or you can bring your own. And you need to make reservations. You need to call 850-722-9032. The Gay family owns and operates the Ikenfina Canoe Liver, and some of the nicest folks you'll ever meet. And there's no telling who you might see when you're canoeing down the creek.
Panama City living is simply better without glasses. The Eye Center of North Florida offers the most advanced surgeries, including lifestyle lens implants for cataract patients and Custom View blade-free LASIK. Both procedures leave you with clear vision, and in most cases, glasses-free. The Eye Center of North Florida.
9 doctors, 1 vision, yours.
Brother John is taking us down the Apalachicola River again this morning. We haven't been down here in over a week. I reckon them old fish has missed us. I know I miss being with them. We're going to try it early in the morning and see if we can get them to bite. It's sure beautiful up here this early in the morning, just after sunrise. When I like to get out. Good spot right there to catch them, by
the way. Pretty thorough up in there.
Yeah. River's up just a little bit. And I even won't hit long as I got my camera on it. By them old cypress knees. Boy, that's a pretty place for a big old hand paint. I got the first one. Boy, he's a dandy. He's just about as big as the fly.
Almost had the second one.
Almost had the second one. Put it, oh, man. He ought to hit you right there, brother. Boy, there's pecans on these trees. The squirrels going to be happy. Looks like they already had them all eaten off. Yeah, these pecan trees are just full of nuts.
There's the first. Bluegill, let's see if he's bad enough to eat. Mm-hmm. I need 10.
You want 10. Yep. I don't want any, so.
Yep, that one's fat enough to eat.
It's fat enough to eat, yep. Huh? Put him in the box. Right here by these
folks. Not a real big one, but he'll do.
Right here by the campers. Nice brim, but he's poor. You don't want to eat him. Mm-hmm. Well, hand him back here to me, and I'll take him off talking about my fish. I agree with you. I don't know, for some reason or other, it seemed like the last month, bud, the fish have been poor on both rivers, really. We fished down here at Appalachia. We fished them on the Chalkahatchee. Looks like they're not in too good a shape.
Yeah.
I tell you something else that gets my attention is the lack of seeing reptiles. I have not seen an old water snake. I don't believe this summer. They used to just lie up on the bushes and scare all the women folks, and nor alligators. Last time I was down here, I saw one little over 3-foot alligator, and that's all. Something is happening to them. But it's like we got another eater. You notice how nice. Thank you. Is he a eater?
Marginal.
Yeah. You notice how nice these people are down here, bud?
Yeah.
How the eye will buy you. You know, I noticed that at the dock the other day when we were trying to load up and people were waiting their turn, and they go down and unload their boat and get out of the way, and just courtesy. And I reckon that's where it ought to be. Most people are nice people, not to be around and fish around and show a lot of courtesy, and I appreciate fishing around.
Yeah, a lot of people think that, well, if you slow down, you'll make a big wake, but disturbing fish just to go by a wide open and
yeah.
Any more hurt. Like them people just went by and like about threw me out of the boat.
Got some color, have you, bro?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, oh, yeah. Nice. Nice hand paint there. Nice hand paint.
Brown, he's good shape, too.
I got a snump knocker. How about a bass there, bud? You don't want him, do you?
No, I don't want him.
Don't want the bass? Yeah, all right, bud. Let's put him back. Here, give me a good little pull there, though.
He's almost long.
Yeah. Bro, that's a pretty good stump knocker, there.
Yes, it is. Fine stump knocker.
Yeah, I'll be there in better shape than the brim.
Yeah. Stump knocker usually can manage to get something to eat.
It's Kubota Summertime Deal Days at Soul Tractor, and finance offers are heating up.
Right now, we have long-term finance rate for qualified buyers. We have the deals you've been waiting for on new Kubota RTV Work or Play.
Come take a look at the new Kubota RTV Work Play utility vehicles today.
Hurry to Soul Tractor's Kubota Summertime Deal Days and get your best deal on a new Kubota today while the sun shines.
Hi, I'm Rick, owner of Affordable Appliance Repair. With over 40 years experience, we offer $29.95 service call fees anywhere in Bay County, plus 10% discounts to our senior citizens, military, police, and fire departments.
If you're tired of high appliance repair costs, call us, Affordable Appliance Repair, 215-2550. That's 215-2550.
Did you know there were over 1,600 burglaries in Bay County in 2010? Don't let this happen to you. Hi, I'm Todd Bryant, owner of Bay Security Company. With over 22 years combined experience, our company is the one to trust with the safety and security of your family or business. Bay Security Company offers 24-hour burglary and fire protection, access control, pool and medical alerts, and cable and telephone installation. So call Bay Security Company today and rest easier tonight.
Hi folks, I'm BJ with BJ's Marine. This has been a family-owned and operated business for over 20 years. We pride ourselves in the sales and service of Nissan and Tohatsu outboards. At BJ's, we have factory-trained and authorized technicians for Nissan and Tohatsu. We also repair most any make or model outboard. Call or come by BJ's Marine Service at 1317 Transmitter Road. And folks, we really do appreciate your business.
My name's Captain Rick Corley. I'm a SAMS accredited Marine Surveyor, NAMS certified Marine Surveyor, and IAMI certified Marine Investigator. Been surveying since 1969. Was taught by my father, who is the oldest, longest practicing Marine Surveyor in the world. We do all types of survey, commercial or pleasure, steel, aluminum, fiberglass, wood, makes no difference. Give us a call at 850-527-5287 or visit us online. We'd appreciate your visit.
All right, so we were fishing with Roy Ray. We were up in West Bay, and we were getting narrower and narrower and narrower. He told me that speckled trout was in just that little creek, and I can't tell you the name of that. But anyway, so we're going up that creek, and the boat is basically touching the banks of the creek, but we're catching one fish after another. So I was very, very excited, and I wanted to continue fishing. And he says to me, No, we gotta stop right now. I said, why? Well, because there is this thing up there, creek. So I said, well, what do you mean, thing? He says, well, the gator man. I started to laugh, and I was laughing. So we were fishing another maybe 10, 15 minutes, and then we hear this bizarre sound. It sounded like something big was chomping on bones, basically, okay? It's something like a teeth grinding a bone, eating a bone. And Roy looks up at me and says, you see, you know, this is the gator, man. I'm like, yeah. Well, sort of in a distance, there was a clearing there. We see something bigger than a man, but smaller than, you know, let's say a big ape or something like that. So we knew it wasn't anything in a costume, you know, because people put costumes and do sort of thing. And it was dark, it wasn't black, but it was sort of brown. It was not a bear standing on the legs. We've seen many bears. And it was chomping on something. And it kind of caught an eye, you know, of our boat, and maybe took three or four steps towards us. And we were, at that point, not very happy. We were turning that boat as fast as we can. And I tell you, the problem was that it was so narrow there that we basically had to get out of the boat, get our feet wet, and just manually move the boat. Well, when that thing saw our movement, it kind of took off. Well, Roy Ray's boat runs maybe 20 miles an hour. I think that day we were running out of the creek at 55 miles an hour. Okay? He was running the engine and I was paddling. And we also caught a little bit of a wind in my jacket as well. So maybe it was 60 miles an hour. We were getting out of there fast.
Hey, I hope you folks enjoy that. The pecan worms are just beginning to fall, so usually September is the best month to catch those brim under those pecan trees down there. Anyway, Doc, again, thank you for being here. Let me tell you about this fella right here. As you saw, he's a jack of all trades. And when he retires from being a physician, he's a gastroenterologist, and he is about one of the only doctors I trust with this old body of mine. It's about worn out. He's my personal physician, really. And I'm going in a few days and have my colonoscopy. Anyway, I'm going to have it, and if you haven't had one lately, you need to have one.
And when I retire, I'm taking over his practice.
No, he's going to go. He's going to go in the
moon. That white boat over there, and I'm going out in the bay with people, and I'm going to fish. That's
you. I think you're going to go to Hollywood after seeing that gator man.
That was good. I like that.
Anyway, Doc is a. I think that we're blessed to have him in our town to take our stomach problems to, whatever it might be, and. I tell you what, Cheryl, you could go in there with double pneumonia, and I believe he'd come out of his office feeling good.
You'll get some good jokes and have some good laughs.
Yeah. But sure enough, being serious, the folks, you need to have a colonoscopy. And he talked me into getting one. He said it was 10 years ago. It didn't seem like it was about three.
No, it was 10 years ago. 10 years ago, yeah.
10 years ago. So every 10 years.
For somebody who has no other problems, there is no need to do it more often.
Absolutely. Unless you have a family history.
Unless you have a family history or you find polyps or other problems. Overall, colonoscopy is overutilized. Too many are being done, really. Polyps grow very slow. You don't have to have it as often as media portray.
You know, he said, he told me that you removed some, you measured that big. I don't know, I was asleep, didn't know it. Easiest thing I ever had done, Cheryl. I'd a lot rather have a colonoscopy than to go to the dentist. Telling you right now. But he said that some of those would have been colon cancer.
Polyps can turn into colon cancer. There are two varieties of them. Some of them are just benign little skin tags, I call them. But there is the other variety that can turn into colon polyps. Colon cancer, I'm sorry. If you have these type of polyps, then you need to have it maybe in 5 years, not in 10-year period.
So, I tell you, 10 years has really flown. In fact, time has flown by.
Time is flying by.
We were just talking about Doc, you've been in Panama City 18 years.
Since 1994, correct.
And that's how long he's been putting up with me. I made him soon after he came here, and we've done a lot of fishing and hunting together, and I just enjoyed his company. And you were telling me about, you know, one of the most fun trips I've been on in a long time was the day we went out with John Law, and we caught a bunch of fish, let me tell you.
That's correct. John, that was 2 years ago, deep sea fishing, 2 or 3 years ago. That's what we've been doing this summer, mostly deep sea fishing. Somehow I haven't gotten out in the bay that much with John Law and with Benji Kelly. Of Kelly family. He has a big boat. On Benji's boat you can take more people, so you can go a little bit further. It's a little bit faster boat, but John's boat is also very good. And we've been catching limit and snapper and other fish almost every time we went. Of course, with a lot of restrictions that we have right now, it's hard because in August, for example, really there wasn't very much you could fish for, more than trigger fish and beeliners and, you know, little small reef fish, because everything else, you know, it was illegal. But now, 15th of September, grouper is going to be opening. Oh, yeah. Amberjack is open already. Yeah. And I just read in the paper the other day that there may be a six-day snapper season in October.
I heard that.
That would be very nice. Mm-hmm. That would be some fish for
right now. Let's just say it's a rumor.
It's a rumor.
It's a good rumor.
But gator hunting started this weekend. Okay.
Did you go?
I didn't go this weekend, but I am going very soon. I have my tags in Gulf County, so I'm going with young family in Gulf County, and it will be successful as ever. Every time we go, we get a gator.
Now, is that something that I guess you, like you pre-fish for a tournament, do you go out and kind of pre-hunt for the gator, or do you kind of know where they bed?
These people that I go with, they've been doing this for a long time, and before season starts, 2 or 3 weeks, they will ride around anywhere from Wewahitchka south to St. Joe, all these waterways, you know, Howard's Creek, different landings, Apalachicola River, Lake Wimlico, intracoastal waterway, and they check out the situation. They look for gators, they you know, try to suss out the situation. Plus people talk, and you will hear from people, well, there is a big gator there, or there is a big gator there, somewhere else. So then we go and at night, you know, and we look at that, you know, and sometimes we'll find a big gator, sometimes we won't, but they more or less know where they're going. It's like fishing with Roy. I mean, he will find you fish, you know, no matter what, no matter what conditions, whether you have fuel on your boat,
true.
Whether you have a boat, okay, you have only a paddle standing in the water, you're still going to catch fish with him.
Doc, I've already invited to come to my land, honey. You don't have to. We've got to take a break, haven't we, Cheryl?
We do. Yeah.
Okay, we'll be right back.
Whether it's removing dangerous trees or planting new ones, Gulf Coast Tree Specialists can help you with all your tree care needs. Sometimes your tree problems are too big for you to handle. Even if it seems impossible to remove your tree, our licensed, bonded, and insured professionals can always find a way for a fair and reasonable price. We can also remove large and unusual items from your property. And our certified arborists can analyze root problems and evaluate structural issues. At Gulf Coast Tree Specialists, we would like to thank you for your continued support and service over the past 20 years and look forward to serving you in the future.
Hi, this is Nate with Mexico Beach Marina, formerly Marquardt's Marina here in beautiful Mexico Beach. Remember, we're a key dealer for Yamaha outboards as well as a 5-star certified service department and are proud now to be a new dealer for Edgewater Powerboats. Our marina store still offers all your latest tackle, live bait, bulk ice, ethanol-free fuel, and slip rentals. And our beach store has everything you need for your day at the beach with Guy Harvey, Salt Life, Sperry, Topsider, Hook and Tackle, Bimini Bay, and much more. So come on down and see us in Mexico Beach.
Silly Willy Lures. Catch fish. Throw it at redfish or speckled trout or mackerel or anything that comes swimming by. Try the Pompano swim jigs. Add some shrimp and you've got a fish catching machine. Silly Willy spoons and jigs and Pompano swim jigs from Fish on Lures. Check them out at CaptainJoeFishing.com. Good lures, good prices. You'll find them at Better Bait and Tackle Shops. Silly Willy Lures. Sounds silly. Catches fish.
Sunjammers on Highway 79 has you covered this winter for all your fishing needs.
No one can seem to get Georgia to reveal her secret to catching those big redfish. So we've placed a series of hidden cameras on Stan and Georgia's boat to try to find out her secret.
Stan, this looks like a good spot right here.
So you think this is a spot?
I know it is.
Okay, well, I'll get the trolling motor ready and we'll get started. You never cease to amaze me, baby.
Stand stuff. It's good on everything.
Check all the stuff in your pantry. If you don't see any stand stuff, it ain't complete.
We've been talking about media and business promotion and social media. Social media are unbelievably, you know, this is just a phenomenon that is new, but is blossoming. We have a website on Panama City Gastroenterologists on Facebook, which provides updates on medical conditions, colonoscopies, etc., etc. This contents changes every week, every 2 weeks or so. Everything is up to date, hot off the press, and it's easy accessible on Facebook.
Facebook.
Check you out on Facebook.
Hey,
Very cool.
I got to say a good morning this morning to Joe Allen up in Malone, Florida. Joe watched the show Saturday. He was just thrilled by seeing the man catch a redfish off of a board, standing on a board. And anyway, Joe was a little bit confused about Stan Stuff seasoning. He called, wanted to know where to get some. He said, "I'm going to put some on my bait like Georgia did." I explained to him, folks, you put Stan Stuff on the fish after you catch him. That's what it's made for. Hey, I had some on my egg this morning.
That stuff is good. I love it.
But we got sweepstakes coming up this month.
We do. We still have our sweepstakes, and we're going to be giving away a UPRO rod, a canoe trip for two people from the canoe livery, a fishing trip with Jody Wells as a guide over on Lake Seminole, fishing trip for two people with Captain Roy. We'll be giving some hats away, some Stan Stuff, and some decals. So go to outdoors@CaptainRoy.com. and get your entry in. And if you don't have a computer, you can call at 722-9382. Make sure you put your telephone number on it so we can call you.
And be sure and check my website. If you go to my website and you just, you can go from there to YouTube,
mm-hmm.
Or you can go to Facebook, or you get the international weather. Mm-hmm. And you can, I try to keep the fishing report. You can get the click on fishing report, and folks, it's what I know and not something somebody's told me when I put on my fishing report. So CaptainRoy.com will just tie you together to our whole network. We got to get out of here.
We need to go fishing.
Let's go fishing. So folks, thank you all for watching the show. Thank you, Doc, again for letting us come down.
It's Duchess.
I like that.
remember to watch our show next Saturday at 5 o'clock on WMBB. Channel 13, and remember to always
try to be as good to him as he is to you.
Good day.
Finally, death came calling for the small town southern man. He said, "It's all right, 'cause I see angels and they got me by the hand. Don't you cry and don't you worry, I'm blessed and I know I am. God has a place in heaven for a small town southern man." And he bowed his head to Jesus, and he stood for Uncle Sam, and he only loved one woman, was always proud of what he had. He said his greatest contribution is the ones he'll leave behind, raised on the ways and gentle kindness of a small town southern man. Raised on the ways and gentle kindness of a small town southern man.
Okay, folks, it's time to wrap it up and go to the barn.